Hey, thanks for checking out my channel. Today I'm going to cover how to create 3D tunnels in DaVinci Resolve. It's really fast and easy to do in Resolve. And shout out to Ken Stout who asked me to put this together. And so here it is. Here's what it looks like. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button if you're new to the channel, and you can get a lot more content like this coming your way. So we'll dig right into this project. And so I'm in the edit page. To get there, hit the shift and number 4 button, and I'm going to add an effect here. It's a fusion composition, and I'm going to stretch that out to 8:10 seconds. That'll work for me. And I'm going to go to the fusion page, hit the shift and 5 button. With the media out as my start point, I don't have anything in the scene currently. So what I want to do is I want to create some rings first. And the easiest way to do that is to use the new fusion shapes. And we can right click in the flow area, click add tool, go to shapes, and we're going to add an S ellipse here and do it again. And we're going to add a S render. You always have to have a render with a shape. I'll plug in that shape into the render. Bring it over to the right window here, and you can see I just have a simple circle. I could have done that with the ellipse tool here, but I'm going to show you some of the advantages of using a shape tool. Click the ellipse tool, go ahead and turn off the solid here, and I'll need to bump up the width to get something to show up here. And we can change the color up here under style. I'm going to change this to kind of a light blue here, something like that. And so I want to do one more thing here. I want to make a copy of this ellipse and paste it. And then right click again and say add tool. And I want to add an S merge tool. If you don't like clicking in there, you can hit the shift spacebar button. And you can search for these S merge. Just like that. I'm going to, instead going right out into that render, I want to go into my merge this time. With both of these tools, and then I'll go out to the render from there. So right now this is just a copy, so I'm gonna slightly modify that. And the reason I did two different tools is to get two different colors. That's important. I could have done a duplicate or something like that to get an additional ring, but it would have both been the same color. So I want to use a different color here. So this one I want to go to kind of a gray, something like that. And under the controls, I want to change the size of this. So to make them equal, just right click on height and select expression. This little plus here, connect it to the width. And then when I move the width, it's going to change the height as well. So then I can get a second ring in there. I'm going to make that slide in a little bit. And I'll make this one quite a bit bigger here. Same thing here. I'm going to select the width and I'll just adjust that until it touches. Okay, so I have my two rings here, and basically it just creates an image of that circle. And so if I go out, that's all we're going to see in the edit page. So I need to put this in 3D space now. To do that, let's grab a billboard here. This is an image plane in 3D space. And then I will grab a merge 3D. And let's take a look at that. You can see the only thing in my scene now is that single ring. So I'm going to hit the shift spacebar and type in duplicate. So I want a duplicate 3D node. And I'll export that merge into. Let me rearrange this. I want the image plane going into the duplicate 3D and then into the merge. So the duplicate 3D, make sure that that is selected so we can inspect the properties here. And what we want to do is change the number of rings here. So I'm going to do 25 rings, and I'm going to offset that in the Z direction. So you can see I have all these really cool rings there, which is really nice. All right, so let's do one more thing. Select this image plane here and shift spacebar, and we're going to type in soft. I'm going to add a soft glow to that node. And we have a little bit of gain, a little bit of glow size. Let's take a look. If we render this, put a render node on here, what does that look like in the left side here? Let's put a camera on here to control this a little bit. And go to the transform settings on the camera. Pull this camera back a little ways. Probably a little bit more. Okay, that's a good starting point. So this looks pretty basic at this point. What I want to do now is I want to take some settings on this glow. Move it down just a little bit on the gain and the glow size as well. I want to right click on the gain and modify it with a perturb. And so now we'll have a modifier here that we can control, and we can change the randomness or reset the value of the starting point. I want to change the strength up a little bit of wobble and a little bit of speed there. And then let's go ahead and animate the camera just to get something down here. I'll start at the far left side of the timeline. That's very important. And I'm going to set a keyframe there. And let's go over to the far right side of the timeline around 240. I'm going to slide this camera so it passes through. Let's take a look at that in the edit page. All right, I gave that a second to cache the memory here. And if you see a red bar here, it's just trying to, your computer's trying to render that internally. So it takes a few seconds or a few minutes if you have a slower computer. So if we play that now, you can see we have a movement through this 3D tunnel here. I'm not real happy with that. So you can see a couple of things I did wrong here. So probably these rings are too wide, and I need some more space in between the rings to kind of create that tunnel effect flying through space. So let me go ahead and make those adjustments in Fusion. So back on the ellipse, we can set the border width down a little bit. And the second one, the gray one as well, I'm going to bring that down a bit. And I'm making the gray ring a little bit bigger to connect in with that blue one. And just get them the way that you'd like them. And for the spacing, go to the duplicate 3D. We want to set the offset. Space that out a little bit more there. Then we'll really have some separation. So we'll go with this. And I need to check my camera, my animation. So here we're starting back here. Let me just look at the render. And I want to get all the way through the tunnel, so I need to increase kind of the position of the Z at the end. That looks great. Give it a second to cache this on my memory again. And here's what the new ring video looks like. I'm very happy with that. I want to go ahead and add a background onto this project. So I'm going to move the Fusion composition up, and I have this starry sky image. I'm going to put beneath it. This 3D Fusion composition does have a transparent background. So you can put any background underneath it that you want. This free image came from Pixabay. It was from the user Felix Mittermeier. And there's the link in the description if you want to grab that for your project as well. And that wraps up the 3D tunnel effect. I've got another version of this 3D tunnel. It's with words, and that'll be coming out shortly on my channel. Hey, thanks a lot for watching. If you got any questions, post them in the comments below. Otherwise, have a great day, everybody.